going into hiding. He said it would be very hard for us to live cut off from the rest of the world. He sounded so serious, I felt scared. Don't worry, Anka. We'll take care of everything. Just enjoy your carefree life while you can. Carefree? I was born in Frankfurt on June 12, 1929. Because we're Jewish, my father emigrated to Holland in 1933. He started a business manufacturing products used to make jam. But Hitler invaded Holland on May 10, 1940, a month before my 11th birthday. 5 days later, the Dutch surrendered, the Germans arrived, and the trouble started for the Jews. My father was forced to give up his business. We couldn't use streetcars, couldn't go to the theater or movies anymore, couldn't be out on the street after 8 p.m., couldn't even sit in our own gardens. We had to turn in our bicycles. No beaches, no swimming pools, no libraries. We couldn't even walk on the sunny side of the street. My sister Margot and I had to go to the Jewish school. Our identity cards were stamped with a big black J, and we had to wear the yellow star. Somehow life went on. Until yesterday, when a call-up notice came from the SS, Margot was ordered to report for work in Germany to the Westerbork transit camp. Call-up. Everyone knows what that means. At 5:30 this morning, we closed the door of our apartment behind us, 10 days earlier than my parents had planned. My cat was the only living creature I said goodbye to. The unmade beds, the breakfast things on the table, all created the impression we'd left in a hurry. And our destination? We walked 2.5 miles in the pouring rain all the way to Father's office building. Our hiding place, the secret annex, is right behind it upstairs. Even though the Germans forced Father out, he still runs the office with Mr. Crawler and me, who agreed to help us while we're in hiding.
Come on!
Thank you, Mr. Clark. squirt. No problem. Oh, you'll tell them about the noise?
I'll definitely.
Thank you. I never thought I would live to see a day a man like Mr. Frog would have to go in hiding.
What a journey. Imagine them walking down the street carrying a hat box and wearing a fur coat. This one we were caught.
What do you need another hat for?
Oh, it's not a hat, it's...
Oh.
I just don't feel at home without my shaver and fly.
Now everyone, a few things quickly. We have to get organized before it. Ah! Sit down. First, about the noise. All the workmen are on the building from 8 until 6. We must be absolutely quiet. No shares, please. And move only when absolutely necessary. We can't run any water. We can't flush the toilet in the WC. The lights go down through the warehouse, and every sound can be heard.
Lunch run for all of us?
No trash can ever be thrown out. Not even a potato. We'll burn everything in the furnace tonight. We can't go outside, of course. We can't even look out a window. No coughing, and if possible, no fevers. Remember, we can never call a doctor. This is the way we have to live until it is over. But after 6, we can talk, laugh, play games, and move around just as we would at home. This will be our common room. We'll all meet and have supper like one family.
One family, I love that.
No, I think we had better get started, Jim. As Mr. Fondant and I discussed, this floor will be the Fondant home, the lower floor and the front floor. I know your space is tiny, Peter, but you will be near your parents. And I actually am glad you brought that cat. Meat warns us there could be rats.
Rats of God.
I'm sure we wish you could take care of a few rats.
Now, may I help you with your things?
No, thank you. Come, Petronelle, we'll go upstairs, bring our dishes down. So our box is already up there.
Never can I thank you, Mr. Frank. I don't know what would happen to this work for you.
You don't know how much of a help your husband was when I first came out. Going home, unable to speak the language. I could never repay him. Besides, he's been an excellent business partner.
Well, that's true.
God, it's hot in here.
If you take that fur coat off for a minute, it would be a lot cooler.
You rested. You haven't closed your eyes since yesterday. Nor you, Mom.
I saw Father. It's not funny, even though I knew it was the last night in my own bed.
Oh, you can sleep through anything. Now, take off your shoes before you forget. Use your bag. Shoes.
You're sure you're not
in
the color? Please, I'm fine.
Variety, isn't there?
I'm gonna miss those gourmet meals.
Oh, please stop exaggerating.
The women seem content, don't they?
Well, you can never tell with women. But I think we'll be all right.
Good. Mrs. Fonda, we'll meet here at 6. We'll start with prayer, so.
6 o'clock, yes.
Come away from the kitchen, Petronella. The workmen will be here at any moment.
Maybe it was a mistake on us. All of us going to hiding together. It saves our family from suffering. That way, we're betrayed. Con, at least the children.
It's a perfect hiding place.
The children wouldn't have understood if we had separated. They couldn't have borne us. No more than they do. No, we must be quiet now.
Don't
girls. Especially a girl like Veronica.
Give him time.
How much time does he need? Come on, Margo, you dance with me.
I have to help with supper.
You don't practice, we'll forget how.
All right.
See, everyone? Margo's the real dancer.
You have to write about that's so important.
Just because someone's young, Mr. Mondon, doesn't mean they don't know what to say.
Oh, please, means I have any privacy.
Petrina, could you tell me what could possibly be so private?
Oh, but you know, at that age, everything's part of you. Brushing your teeth.
So long as she doesn't write anything about me in that private diary of hers.
Don't be ridiculous. Really, pretty, you're so childish.
Haven't you finished your French yet? You ought to be ashamed.
I know, I'm hopeless.
You're not helpless. He's not hopeless. He just doesn't want him to help you like the girls do. Maybe you could help him, Mr. Frog.
Oh, I'm sure his father would.
Not me.
much depth you're on.
Listen to Mr. Frog, Peter. Mr. Frog is a highly educated man.
Aren't things hard enough without you being sprawled all over the place?
No, you wouldn't be still tougher if you didn't smoke so much.
Am I smoking? Do you see me smoking?
Don't tell me stuff all those secrets already.
One package. You brought me one package.
Well, it's a hard habit. It's a good time to break it.
Oh, leave me alone.
You smoke your father's money. You know that, don't you?
Will you shut up? And what are you staring at?
I never heard of a squirrel like that before. I thought only children crawled and then they were after to eat you up.
It wasn't a quarrel. It was a discussion. And I never met children so rude before.
I? Rude? I don't know how you can say that.
Oh,
no, you.
Could you please bring me my knitting? I must remember to ask me for some more wool. I have a library book for the repair and I need some hair samples, so.
Please, me. Get me some tea, some starch, some biscuits, a movie star magazine. Tell us all the latest news, me. It's a wonder she's a life at her own. Did you know she's engaged to a man called Jan? She's crazy about it, but she's terrified the Nazis will send them to Germany to work in a war plant.
Suppose you keep still for 5 minutes. Talk, talk, talk. Chatter, chatter, chatter. It's the one way everyone discovered and shot. Why do you have to show up all the time? Why can't you be like your sister and be a good girl?
Not me. I'm going to be remarkable. I'm going to Paris.
Really?
I'm going to be a famous singer or a dancer or...
Oh my God! My coat! My beautiful fur coat!
I'm sorry.
You know what my father paid for this? Look at it!
I'm very, very sorry.
I could kill you for this!
Petronella!
Tried, but there are no more ration books to be had.
We're 7 Canadians, 8 Canadians, well.
I I hope so.
If we can save even one person, we must.
Of course, you're right.
Yes, definitely. Mr. Crawler will go to meet him. I will bring him up.
Tomorrow.
Thank you. It's fine to have him, but where are we going to put him?
He can have my bed. I'll sleep on the floor.
That's very kind of you, Peter, but there's probably enough room in there for you.
I know. I'll move in with you and Mother, and you can have my bed.
No. No, no. Margo will move in with us, and it doesn't have her bed. It's the only way.
Why can't I move in?
Because it wouldn't be proper for Margo to... Please, Anna. Don't argue. It's settled.
Dreaming. Mr. Frank, Mr. Otto Frank, I heard you were in Switzerland. A patient of mine told me you'd escaped to Basel, or Belgium, or someplace.
That's what everyone thinks. The Nazis included, we hope.
We tricked them.
We're so glad
you've
come, Mr. Duffel.
All of us are.
How can I thank
you? Not us. Me and Mr. Crowley.
Help them.
Aren't you scared, me? Sometimes?
We're not heroes.
Leif, you're being too modest.
We just don't like the Nazis. Anything about them.
Now, Mr. Dussel, have a seat. You must be worn out.
Let's have a toast to Mr. Dussel.
Oh, yeah, you were saving in case of illness, but...
And what better way to use it? To Mr. Dussel, we're honored to have you with us.
Prost.
Prost.
Delicious. Too bad there's so little of it.
I believe we know someone in common with this, huh? Dr. Kinsler. We were friends back in the old days in Frankfurt. What? What is it?
Dr. Kinsler was taken last month. Beethovenstrasse. They took the whole block.
What's happening outside?
Tell us, Mr. Muscle.
All over Amsterdam, Jews are disappearing. Some torn out of bed in the middle of the night. My God, the screams. Children come home from school to find their parents missing. Women come home from shopping to discover their families vanished. It's impossible to escape unless you go into hiding. Thousands are being reported. Bloomberg's, Professor Hallenstein,
oh God, no.
You have 5 minutes to get ready. Bring only what you can carry in a rucksack. Herd it into the Jewish theater for days, sometimes weeks, and then festival, the transit camp. From there, like clockwork, every Tuesday, a train leaves for the East.
Mr. Vessel, do you know the Gosslers? Their daughter Hanelli and I have been friends since we were four. They didn't come with them, did they? Not Hanelli, no.
There was another family by the name of...
No!
I'm sure Mr. Dustin needs to get settled before supper, David. I'm sorry we can't offer you your own room, but I trust you won't mind sharing one with my daughter.
Forgive me for upsetting you.
No, you had to tell them. We had to know.
Why don't you show Mr. Dustin your room?
Thank you, me, for everything.
Best.
Every night, Mrs. Fromm, every night. She's putting us all in danger.
Go back to bed, Mr. Hustle. She'll be all right in a minute.
All right.
What happened? Sounded like someone was murdering her.
Shall I get you some water? It was a bad dream, wasn't it, my name? Want to tell me about it? Sometimes it must drink some water. I see. Well, try to sleep then. I'll sit right here for
you. I'd rather you didn't.
I see. Good night, then. Could you send Father in? Please?
Hey, Liz.
It's all right. Go to her, Autumn. She's still trembling.
It's just a phase.
You weren't like this.
I'm more like you. It's not that she doesn't love you.
And I dreamt they broke through the bookcase and took us all away. The train going to the east. Did I yell terribly loud? Do you think anyone heard outside? I know what you're thinking, but I just don't love her.
Anna!
I hate being cooped up with her. I don't get along with anyone here. In my nightmares, I know everyone hates me for having them, but I can't stop them from coming.
We're all having nightmares, honey. You look at them.
Your mother's having nightmares, too. Horrible ones. She's going through a very hard time.
I know, Pam. I know I have a different side. A finer, better side. But it's as if I'm split in half. What's good, what's bad, I don't know. I want to be a better person. But not if it means shutting myself off, hiding how I feel.
I understand. We've always understood each other doing that. You know, you taught me something when we first came here.
Me?
Remember when we first arrived? How numb Argo and your mother were? I was a wreck with worry, but you... That terrible morning, you skipped around the room, calling it an adventure. You showed me that you could escape. Now, when I read my books, they take me into another world. In that world, I feel safe. You have something, too. A diary. When I see you fill it up, I know you found your world. You're lucky, Anna.
Lucky?
You can write. You can put all your thoughts down on paper.
Be back in school with my friends, swim, ride a
wonder if anyone will ever think of me as just a teenager, not whether I'm Jewish or not. Just as a teenager, badly in need of some playing fun. Margot said,
I want to go dancing and learn the latest stuff and fly across the room in a new pair of dancing shoes.
The movies. I'd love to see a movie. Maybe a Western, if they ever let us back in.
I'm longing for a real cup of coffee with cream and sugar. No, a whole pot.
A bath, a hot bath in a bathtub, lying there luxuriating for hours. And then Woody comes in and slips my bath.
And Woody said,
cream cakes. First thing out there, I'm going to bed off for some cream cakes.
Charlotte, just to look at it, listen to it. For hours. You know what I want? To pack a picnic lunch and take my family to the seashore for the whole day.
Thank you.
Hermushi. Oh, I know.
Jack's gonna jump out and bite me, right?
What is it?
A razor. Neve got it for me. It's secondhand, but you really do need one now.
What for?
Look at his upper lip. There's a little something growing there.
There is. Well, put a little milk on it and let the cat lick it off.
Think you're funny, do you? Well, I like it. Thank you.
And last but never least, for my roommate, Mr. Bethel.
Got something for me. Capsules. Two capsules. Not poison.
They're earplugs, so you won't hear me thrashing around at night. I made them out of cotton and candle wax. Go ahead, try them, see if they work. Are you ready?
One moment.
Are you ready?
What?
Are you ready?
Oh my goodness. They've gone inside my head. Help! Help! Oh my! Oh, I was joking. I was joking. Thank you.
Oh, Anna, they're wonderful. I don't know how she did it. Wasn't it darling?
Very clever indeed.
One last thing.
What?
One present. Just one.
Who for?
Show us.
It's for your mother. Tonight.
My music box. Oh, Otto, how did you ever...
I saved it. I was hoping it wouldn't be here till Hanukkah, but I brought it along just in case.
This goes all the way back to my great-grandmother. Your father's an angel for saving it.
Why didn't you save anything of mine?
I saved you in time.
Listen.
She loves his presents.
Peter! You're giving me asthma!
What's the matter with you? Get that cat out of here!
What the
cat?
It doesn't have to be the cat. His clothes are enough.
Don't worry, we're getting rid of it.
Finally, you listen to me.
I'm not doing this for you, Dussel. I'm just tired of all those damn fleas.
Mr. Von Don, you can't do that.
That's Peter's cat. Peter loves that cat.
If he goes, I go. So go! Go!
He's not going. His cat's not going. Peter, put your robe away. Come, Mr. Dussel. It's Hanukkah. A time of celebration. Girls, sing a song.
It was a thief.
How do you know?
He took all the money in the cash box. He ran off in such a hurry that he left the front door wide open. I think the noise may have scared him away. Well, danger's past. We're safe.
Maybe. But
We're in even greater danger now.
Mr. Russell, please.
Now someone knows we're up here.
Wait a minute. Why are you pointing at him? It was an accident. It could have happened to any one of us.
Are you telling me you think a thief is going to go to Green Police and start robbing someplace the other night and I heard a noise above my head? You think a thief is going to say that?
Yes, I do.
Oh, you're crazy.
I think one day he'll get caught and he'll make a bargain with the Green Police. If they let him off, he'll tell them where some Jews are hiding. Maybe they'll even reward him. You know what Meade said. 7.5 guilders for every Jew found in hiding.
He's right.
Father, we can't stay here. Let's go. Let's just go.
Go?
Where would we go?
Into the street?
No one's leaving. We can't panic. If we panic, we're lost. Now, we've survived up here for 6 months together, and we're going up. Margo. Anna. The song,
please. Sometimes I feel like I'm alone in a dungeon, without mother or father. Or I'm roaming the streets, or the annex is on fire, or they come and take us all away.
I see the 8 of us in the annex, as if we're a patch of blue sky surrounded by menacing black clouds. The perfectly rounded bottom which we stand is still safe, but the clouds are moving in on us, and the ring between us and the approaching danger is being pulled tighter and tighter. We're surrounded by darkness and danger, and in our desperate search for a way out, we keep bumping into each other. We look at the fighting down below and the peace and beauty above, but we're cut off by the dark mass of clouds and can go neither up nor down. It looms